Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to the stage founder and CEO of CLEMCO.AV and director of Living the Dream Audiovisual Leadership Academy, Clem Herod.
Look, all I wanna do is make the city proud, yeah. Wishing all the OGs could see me, nah, nah, yeah. And when you feel something you can't see, but you know it's meant to be, you gon' realize that this is bigger than me, yeah.
All right. Hello, everybody. Hello, hello, hello. We are having a wonderful time on our end on the production side, and I hope that you all are having a wonderful time as well. You know, I was at home reflecting one day, and I was having a thought on Dr. King and his I Have a Dream speech. So I was born in Washington, D.C., and I lived in Maryland until I was 12 years old before moving to Miami, Florida. And in that space of reflection and life, I was wondering, because I've been in television production since middle school. So for over 30 years, I've been in the space of media production. And I was thinking about the I Have a Dream speech. But I was thinking about it from the standpoint of, would Dr. Martin Luther King Jr.'s I Have a Dream speech, would it have been as impactful if it weren't for the people who work in the live event production industry? Yes, the message is still the same. But who actually receives the message? If it weren't for the audiovisual technicians who were in the space of setting up the microphones, the cameras, the coordinators who organized the march on Washington itself, and the people who were even a part of scheduling for others to arrive, thinking about the entire event production in itself. And he had it in a space where not as many people heard it, or pictures weren't taken, or audio wasn't recorded. Would we still be talking about it the way that we do today? Would it have that same impact that it has had on the lives of so many? Even in this photo, you see the photographers right behind him, the person with the video camera as well, the photographer that took this shot. Robert Stokely is over here taking pictures of all of us in this very moment. I can look at this image and I can see additional production people in this photo, almost like a whole Where's Waldo moment, because that's how my brain thinks. But then I live in the space of what COVID was and how COVID impacted my industry and the people who were within my industry. And even after COVID, when all live events, or during COVID, when all live events shut down, and in that process where there was a mass exodus of the industry as a whole, to whom do we pass the torch? To whom do we give those skills to? I'm in the second generation of the corporate theater sector of the live event production industry. Within that industry, you've got sports, news, Broadway plays, so Broadway theater, corporate theater, house of worship. I was with my family the other day. We went to the circus down in Sarasota, and I was like, oh my goodness, the circus in itself is a live event, production. Because that's how my brain thinks. And I'm in that moment enjoying it with my family, but realizing that this is something that I can do because I see the speakers. I see the lights. I see every single cable that's run from the source to the destination. And then reflecting back on COVID in those moments where there was so much stress and anxiety and suffering and pain that many of the people in my industry experienced. And I experienced with my family trying to navigate and figure out life in this new world order, if you will. And there were so many people that had something to say, but felt like no one was listening. It's painful. It's hard. How do you move forward? How do you move forward when it feels so dark? Because darkness cannot drive out darkness. Only light, light, like the ones shining on me and the ones coming from the projectors to the screen, like the ones flickering on your tables, like the ones uplighting the room, like the chandeliers being adjusted just so, the chandeliers above my head being turned off, and the cans in the ceilings, and the emergency exits light shining green, the yellows and the greens on the screens and the walls shining just so, the lights, the blue lights outside, and the yellow lights outside illuminating the world, our experience just so. How do you find peace and happiness in that space of darkness? You try to find hope. You try, you pray. What do you pray for? You pray for just one simple glimpse, one moment to grab onto. You ask God, please help make, give me strength to get through this, Lord, please. You ask to make the dream of peace and happiness and hope, love for all mankind, a reality. But how do you do that when you lose your gigs, you lose your income, you lose your career, you lose your friends, you lose your family, you lose what was your life? How do you do that? You look above and you ask for a sign. You ask for a sign. In that space of trying to pass on the torch, what we've done at CLEMCO.AV is to create a framework. And that framework was a dream. That framework was then received and accepted by the MLK Parade Foundation. That framework was turned into the Audiovisual Leadership Academy, the Living the Dream Audiovisual Leadership Academy. Are we living our dreams? Yes, we are. We are creative people. We are structure-driven people living our dream and making it reality and making experiences that you all have and are having right now in this moment. So this is part of the dream that we were able to create for these students over the past 2 days. Please roll the video. And I will wrap. Thank you. So what I want you all to realize is that in the space of passing the torch, as I stand over here in front of house, these students who were just introduced to this industry, high school students, middle school students, young adults, adults, we are passing the torch and showing the next generation how to create these types of experiences.